So ChatGPT 4.0 came out recently, and I thought it'd be a good video to compare ChatGPT 4.0 with ChatGPT 4. So that's what we're gonna do in this video. We're gonna go straight to ChatGPT. Now, I've heard that ChatGPT 4.0 is free for everyone. Now, there may be some limited time that you can use it, but go check yours, see if you can get onto it, chatgpt.com. It's supposed to be free. Maybe it's not out yet, but I have the paid version, so I already have it. But it's supposed to be free for everyone. So you can try this test out as well. So let's go to the internet and go and see what ChatGPT 4.0 can do for graphics. I'm not going to test everything. I know there's speech and text and all these other stuff that it can do, but I'm just going to do graphics for this video because that's what I use it for print on demand. All right, so here we are on chatgpt.com. Before, I believe it used to be chat.openai.com, but if you go there and you click on it, it's just going to change it to chatgpt.com. So that's one of the changes here. And then the next thing you'll notice here in this dropdown, if you have it will say ChatGPT 4.0, so newest and most advanced model. There's still 4 and 3.5, so we can do a comparison on all three of these. I'm just gonna do the comparison between these two to see how much of an improvement 4.0 is from 4. Now it just came out, and I'm sure they're gonna improve more and more, but I think it's a great test to see how good it is right now since it's the newest and most advanced and everything. So I'm gonna do a few prompts. I'm gonna try a few things. I'm gonna drag in a design that we have, see if it can copy it. I'm gonna do some edits on a design. We're gonna do a lot of different things. So first, let's see if it can do a simple thing. Now, I'm not gonna use any of the GPTs here, like StickerWiz or Kawaii Creator. I'm just gonna use the specific or the straight up ChatGPT 4.0, but I'm just gonna ask it to make some designs. So the first one, I'm gonna do real simple, this corgi right here, right? So I'm gonna type in a kawaii corgi eating ramen and have a light yellow circle behind it, just like this one right here. So let's put that in, boom. So just like that. And I'm gonna hit enter, and it's gonna be ChatGPT 4.0. So let's see what it does. It's gonna take a little while, so I'll come back when we see what it does. Okay, so here is ChatGPT 4.0 or GPT 4.0. I believe it's using DALL-E 3. It might be even using something higher than DALL-E 3, if there's a DALL-E 3, 4, or a DALL-E 4, I'm not sure, but it's using, you know, some sort of DALL-E. And check it out. Really cool. Well, except for right here, it looks like the chopstick is broken right here. But overall, the corgi looks great, and the yellow circle behind it looks great. I would cut this out, put it on a t-shirt. I would try and fix this right here. I don't know what's going on here, but let's see if 4 does a better job. So we did 4.0, and the next thing you can do is right here, right in this little thing here, you can change it. So this is 4.0. I can go here and say, let's see what it looks like with 4, ChatGPT 4, and I don't have to type the prompt again. It just does it. So let's see what it comes up with, and then we can kind of compare the two. So here it is. Let me bring it up here. So here's the version 4, just 4, ChatGPT 4 did, not 4.0. And I mean, it's okay, it's pretty cool, but when we compare it to the other one, let's see, I'll turn it down here and you can go back and compare it to this one. I think this one's a lot cuter. I like the lines are a lot thicker. It's just a better kawaii, minus that right there. But as far as layout and everything, let's go here. Right, he's not holding the chopsticks. Now, there's no issue with that, but there's some other issues here. I think, well, it's just a different style, and I like the other style better. He's kind of sitting on a stool, which is kind of cool. It did do the yellow circle better, I believe, but I mean, this is good too. But if I had to score both, let's see both of them on screen right here. If I had to score both, I think I would lean a little bit more to 4.0, but this is just one test. Let's try and test something else. So the next one I'm gonna test is a typographical design. So let's try something. I'm not the best at writing prompts, but I wrote this one and it's pretty detailed. So I'm gonna write, create a cool typographical design on a black background with the text that says, "Bro, we out." We see that a lot for teachers when they're out of school. Have the font for "Bro, we out" be a thick distress style font with each letter a different color. Just the text, no graphics. Have the word "teachers" be in a different font and make it white. So we'll see, I'll put all of that in here and we'll see how good that instruction and how good that prompt is. First of all, I'm on 4.0, right? It changed it back and I'm gonna hit go and let's see what it does. All right, so here we're back. It didn't do different colors. I should have said what colors, maybe that's why. But the typographical thing is pretty cool. It wrote it, it says, bruh, we out, and it looks like it, and the dash teachers, and this is a different font than that font. And you could probably just use this. It is a distress font. And what I would do is I would just knock out the background and it would work. There's some, a little bit of issues. The connection, the E right here probably needs some work, but let's see what it does as 4, just ChatGPT-4, if it does any better. Ah, this is interesting. So here we go. Bro, we out. We can read that a lot better. I guess this is just a stylized thing to have fill the space, right? And out. So it did do the different colors for out, but not bro, we. And then spelled teachers, right? And it's in a different font. So, this is good too. But if we look at both of them, let's go back. This one versus this one. I think it's kind of a personal preference. The other one was too, but this one's easier to read. It's in a tall rectangle. I like what it's doing here. I think I'm gonna give this one to 4. If we had to pick a winner, I think 4 because of the colors. It added the colors there. So very close though. They both spelled it out right. Did pretty good. So the test for this one was to see if it can do a typographical design, and it can. It can do a typographical design. All right. Let's do one more. The next one is to do both. So I use graphics and type. So the first one was just a test for graphics. Can it do graphics? The next one was, can it do just text? But let's see if it can do the combination of the two. I wrote this very long one. I'm not going to read it this time, but it's about monster trucks and kindergarten. You can see right here, vector design, monster truck. And let's see how it does. Oh, pretty cool. Let's check this out. I crushed kindergarten. Well, it didn't spell kindergarten right, right? So the bro we out, it spelled it right. It did spell I crushed. But what you could do here is you could download this and change this with another font. But pretty cool graphic. Love it that's on fire, graduation and so on. So let's see what this would look like if ChatGPT-4 would do any better. So 4.0, we're gonna change it to 4 right here. Give it a shot and see how much better or worse it does it. All right, so here's 4's version. I crushed, this looks like an I in here. Kindergarten, dang it, it was so close. But again, the graphic is good. I think putting the graphic with the design or text with the graphic, sometimes not a great idea, but the graphic is really cool. I would come in here, if I were to use this, I would come in here, obviously change the words on here, but the graphic is really cool. So which one's better? Wow, tough. This one, I did say add flames, and this one, I don't know. I guess I have to give it, I crushed was spelled right, kindergarten was spelled way wrong. I crushed was spelled wrong, kindergarten was spelled wrong, but I feel like this one was spelled closer to kindergarten. I don't know. I'm giving it to this one, 4.0. Or I mean 4, not 4.0. Now, again, I'm not the best at writing prompts, but Philip Anders is pretty good. And in his last video, I'll put it up here, or not his last video, one of his last videos, he did several ideogram or ideogram prompts. And I'm going to copy 2 of those that I saw. And let's see if those prompts work here in ChatGPT. So these are meant for ideogram, but I'm gonna put them in here and see what happens. This one's about a skeleton and a hammock and so on. So you'll see, and it has text too. So this is both graphics and text. Hopefully maybe his prompt is better than my prompt. We'll see what happens. It took the t-shirt. I think there's t-shirt in here, a vibrant nostalgic t-shirt design, and it thought to put it on a t-shirt. Now it's a pretty cool one. Doesn't work for us because it's on a t-shirt design. I may have to, maybe ideogram knows not to put it on a t-shirt, but ChatGPT didn't. Let's see if ChatGPT-4 knows to not put it on a t-shirt. I'll see what happens. Oh, so 4 knew not to put it on the t-shirt, and this is what it did. It's pretty good. I like it. So I think 4 in this case would win because it's not on a t-shirt. Let's see the other one. I mean, this one's pretty good. I like the artwork on it, but if it was outside the t-shirt, I think it would have been a great contender. Let's see, did it spell it wrong, the first one? Good Vibes Vintage Apparel. No, spelled correctly. Nice colors. It could work. All right, one more, one of the other ones that he did. So this one, the next one that he did is all text. So some graphics, but mostly a text design. And I'm gonna put it right here, again, from Philip Anders. You gotta watch his channel. He has some good stuff, especially with AI stuff. So here's one, let's see what it does. All right, so this one's supposed to say, have faith in yourself, and very colorful. It does say have, Nope, it didn't do it. So that's 4-0. Let's do 4. Let's see what happens and see if it spells it right. So far, 4 seems to be doing better with text right now as it stands. I'm sure they're working on it. But yeah, let's see. Nope. That A and the, so still, you know, still having problems with text, both ChatGPT 4 and 4-0, but the graphics. Text is hit and miss, right? So sometimes it's good, like this one, good Vibes, Vintage Apparel, perfect. Sometimes it's this, it's hit and miss. So you're gonna have to probably, you know, hit it 5 times with the same prompt and see if it comes up. It's kind of a that kind of thing. But I love the designs out here. The flower designs is great on that one. Let's see how good it is on this one. Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Unfortunately, it's really hard to change the text here with just fonts on here because these are kind of customizable fonts. Okay, another thing I want to test is how good is ChatGPT 4.0 with like an image and as a prompt. So I'm going to have one of my images here. So this is my corgi eating ramen, right? And I'm going to say make something like this, but with a cat. They may actually think this corgi is a cat, but maybe I should say what color cat, with a black. Make a design like this. Make a design like this, but with a black cat. Okay, this is 4.0, and you can see that's my design that's up here, right here on a red background. And let's see how close it gets to my design. Hey, not bad. I mean, the text is wrong. We'll have to change that unless that means something else in Japanese. But it is a cat with holding chopsticks with a yellow background. Not bad. And it's black, a black cat. So pretty cool. And it even got kind of the same pattern here on the bowl. All right. Let's see what it does in 4, just 4, not 4.0. Here is ChatGPT 4's version. I mean, it kind of has the same thing. But it doesn't have the same yellow background. It's really dark, in fact. And the cat's kind of holding it in a weird way. But it has the feet like that and the pattern, so not bad. But I think what's closer is this one. This one's a lot closer to that than this one is, in my opinion. So both are pretty cute, though. Okay, so a couple more things I wanted to test. And that is consistency of the same design. So hopefully I'm doing this right. This is what I think should happen. So let's do a cat. Love putting cats on here. So let's do a cartoon cat wearing glasses. All right, so just a very simple prompt. We're gonna see if it can keep the same thing, the same look of it when I say remove the glasses. Just remove the glasses. Same design, remove the glasses. All right, so here's the cartoon cat in 4.0. Now in 4.0, I'm gonna say, keep the cat the same, but remove the glasses. All right, so I would think that it keeps the same design style. Let me just make sure, the same style. Okay, keep the cat the same style, but remove the glasses. Hopefully that's how you're supposed to do it. If there's a different way to do it, let me know in the comments. I may be doing that prompt wrong, but let's see. My hope is that it keeps the same exact cat, but just remove the glasses so we can see their eyes. That's what I'm hoping. Let's see if 4.0 can do it. Keep the same consistent graphic. Well, it kind of looks the same cat, but it still has the glasses. It didn't remove the glasses, but it, I mean, looks very similar. So close, I guess. I don't know. Let's do the same thing with 4. With 4, so I'm going to do 4 here instead of here. A cartoon cat wearing glasses. Okay. So there, and so I'm going to put the same thing that I did. Keep this cat the same style, but remove the glasses. Okay. See if 4 can do it. We're still on 4 up here, so boom. Well, that's a little different, and it still has glasses, which is kind of weird. All right, so one last thing I want to do is let's see how good it is at editing. Now, I'm not going to do it on 4, just do it on 4.0. So I'm going to change this to 4.0, come in here, and we have this edit brush here, and we're going to see if it can remove the glasses. That's all I want it to do. And I'm going to make sure that we have enough space for it to remove the glasses. There, I'm going to remove myself over here on this side, and I'm just going to say edit selection, remove the glasses. All right, this is the last test, 4.0, see if it can do it. Well, there you go. It actually did remove the glasses, but it drew the eyes in a weird way. So the cat was supposed to, before I took away the glasses, it looked like this. So it really changed the eyes and everything. I don't like it, but it did remove the glasses. So I guess half a point. I don't know what you call it. It can do better. It should do better because I wouldn't want these eyes in there. So there you go. That's kind of testing 4.0. Now there are some things that I think could be improved. There are some things that are really cool that we saw up here. Like this first one, I think, was the best example that it did a lot better than 4. So that's it. Hopefully this is really helpful for you. Let me know in the comments which one you liked better, 4.0 or 4, or if you have access to 4.0, if you tried it out, and if I've tried everything, if there's something else that you want me to try with 4.0 for graphics that you would be using for print on demand, let me know that in the comments too. I can make another video. Now, if you want to see the video that I made recently with ChatGPT-4 and the different edit features, I have that video right here where I do the brush and change it all, and it works pretty good, a lot better than the cat one that I just did with removing glasses. So go watch that video. I think you can learn a lot more on edit with that brush. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.